Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, we are going to deploy vCenter server appliance from a template. I have a remote desktop session open into my infrastructure VM, and I have a vSphere client session open into the program infrastructure, which is where we're going to create that virtual machine. I'm going to right click on my folder and select new virtual machine, deploy from template. Select the data center, and in the template VMs, I'm going to select VCSA 6.7. The name is simply going to be my college login, and then dash VCSA as per the lab document that will be in my folder, in my resource pool, on my data store as thin provisioned. We're not going to customize either the operating system nor the virtual machine hardware. Actually, let me back up from that. Yes, we are going to customize the hardware. We have to select the correct port group, and we'll power on when we're finished. So this comes up, find the way it is. Oh, it did grab my port group by default. That's excellent. So we can say next and finish. Here is my VM that will finish copying out and then power up when we're finished with that. It's done. This is powered on. I'm going to pause the video now. We're going to wait for it to fully power up, and then we're going to configure the network. Okay, our virtual machine is booted up. When you see something that looks like this with respect to the console, we know we're ready to go. Going to open a console window. The way we configure IP on this appliance is very similar to the way we were doing with the ESXi hosts before. So I'm going to simply do F2. To log in, and we will see we get a very similar screen to ESXi. So come down to configure the management network, enter. We already have this set for static, but I need to set it to the correct static IP for my network. The subnet mask is fine. The default gateway, of course, is not. IPv6 is fine. We need to configure DNS. The host name is fine, but the DNS server must point at our infrastructure VM IP. If you do not do this correctly, vCenter is not going to work because it can't resolve anything, and that is an absolute requirement for vCenter to work correctly. And then we don't necessarily need a DNS suffix, but having this set to our Active Directory domain is fine. I will escape from here and say yes to restart the management network. And now that that's done, I'll simply escape to log out. And we will be able to see on our screen here that the IP address has changed to the proper IP address for my subnet. And also the FQDN is vcsa.vclass.local. Now it's important to keep our lab simple to make sure that we maintain the domain in that because of the self-signed certificates that are generated when VCSA is installed. You can always go and change those certificates. It's a bit of a pain to do it, but it's definitely possible. We are not going to bother doing that. We're going to make it easy on ourselves. And that is a wrap for installing or deploying, if you wish, VCSA from a template. Hopefully this video has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.